Look up. Look down. Look all around you. What do you see? Hear. Smell. Taste. Feel. You are here. And it's now. But what and who was here before you? 10 years ago? 100? 1,000? Even 50,000 years ago? How did things look, sound, smell, taste and feel back then? What's changed? And what's the same? Where are you? Or, more to the point, when are you? Me? Well, I'm right here. And I can tell you now, things feel great. Not everyone can hack it here, but check it out, human food. It looks and tastes good to me. That's the sound of more on its way. And the smell, well, you might not like it, but believe it or not, that is the smell of the dawning of a new era. One they're saying should be named after you. Yep, little old you. They're calling it the Anthropocene. Anthropo means human. The Anthropocene is the time of the humans. You might be wondering why a time that smells like bin juice is being named after your species. And why a bird you've nicknamed the bin chicken is telling you about it. Yeah, that's right. We know what you've been saying about us. It's about time you got a bird's eye view of things. Throughout the history of planet Earth, big changes have happened. Well before humans were even on the scene. Like ice ages, volcanic eruptions, new life forms, mass extinctions, and moving land masses. My ancestors, the dinosaurs, ruled the world once, in a time called the Jurassic. But due to some unfortunate and unforeseen events, the Earth was pushed into yet another new era of time. Each time period has a name and a story to tell, adding another chapter to the history of planet Earth. So, what makes humans so special that you'd even get this chapter named after you? Believe it or not, humans once worshipped us, the humble bin chickens. Our cousins in Egypt were seen as sacred. And here, in what we now call Australia, we've been respected by human cultures for thousands of years too. It's only recently that things changed. And while some of us have survived and thrived in the cities of today, others have been doing it tough. It turns out not everyone loves the smell of bin juice.
Or the taste of hot chips.
As much as others.
Too right. We've never had this much trouble with people before. Of course, they took one of us for food or even an egg from time to time. They're only human. But nothing was quite like these new humans who arrived in the 19th century. This new bunch treated the land very differently and brought new animals with them too. They decided we weren't welcome here anymore, which led to the Great Emu Wars of 1932, or as we call them, the Great Human Wars. We managed to keep this army of new humans on the back foot at first, but we've lost a lot of ground since then, and we're not the only ones.
Don't get us wrong, humans love animals. It's just that some of their animals don't love us.
On the plus side, I have been able to add some new impersonations to my repertoire.
You can't blame us for getting a bit territorial from time to time.
Or changing our holiday plans because the seasons and the seasides aren't what they used to be.
Human beings are doing just as much to shape the planet as any ice age, volcano, or meteorite has in the past. Yep, humans are definitely the main characters of this chapter. But so far, we only know how it begins. So, what do you think should happen next? You are here. And it's now the beginning of a chapter called The Anthropocene. What will things be like in 10 years from now? 100 years? 1,000 years? Or even 25,000 years from now? How will things look, sound, smell, taste, and feel then? What will change? What will stay the same? Can humans be the heroes of this story? Will we find new ways or rediscover better ways to live and grow together? Could bin chickens rule the world? just a suggestion. You're not just part of this chapter, you're helping to write it. So let's turn a new page and make the Anthropocene a human story we would all love to tell.